Our work focuses on Bird Glacier. In this image, you can see Ross Island near the top and Bird Glacier 200 miles to the south in the bottom left-hand corner. This video will walk you through the steps we took to install a GPS monitoring site above one of these subglacial lakes in the Bird Glacier catchment basin. The first step is to assemble the frame and to drill the holes that will mount that frame into the surface. The holes are drilled about a meter and a half deep and will support a triangle-shaped frame with 350-watt solar panels. While the holes were being drilled for the frame mount, it was also time to cut a hole big enough to fit our box. The box will house 10 batteries, along with the GPS unit and a pair of heating pads. The conditions over an Antarctic winter can be extremely harsh, with temperatures approaching minus 100 degrees Fahrenheit
and winds in excess of 75 knots.
It's very important that we have a sturdy frame. The next step is to mount the 350-watt solar panels, which during the summer months
will aid in the charging of the 10 batteries in the box.
Once the panels have been securely fastened, it's time to start wiring them to the GPS unit. We will also place an antenna for the GPS receiver and a wind turbine to help provide power during the dark Antarctic winter. The white disc that you see mounted on the singular pole
is the GPS antenna, which will be wired to the GPS receiver inside the box.
We are placing two GPS units above a pair of subglacial lakes in the Bird Glacier catchment basin. The idea is to see if these lakes drain periodically and compare those with the results from the GPS units placed on Bird Glacier itself. After making sure all the electronics have been wired properly, and the solar panels and the wind turbine have been tested using a multimeter, the final step is to lay out guy wires to secure and add stability to the solar panel frame. Using satellite observations, changes in surface elevation can be determined. As water fills the lakes below the glacier, it forces up the overlying snow and ice. This can be picked up by our GPS instruments.
As the water then begins to drain from those lakes,
our GPS units will then be able to determine any drop in elevation from the draining water. As the water drains from the subglacial lakes above Bird Glacier, it is hypothesized that the water flowing down underneath the glacier will actually provide lubrication and cause the glacier to speed up. Our network of 25 GPS units on Bird Glacier will help to determine if this is the case. Once the water stops flowing, the glacier is likely to slow back down. The Bird Glacier field team consists of Principal Investigator, or PI, Dr. Lee Stearns, Assistant Professor at the Center for Remote Sensing of Ice Sheets at the University of Kansas, Dr. Gordon Hamilton, Associate Professor at the University of Maine, graduate students Brandon Gillette, Kristen Shield, and Nora Weitz, and Mountaineers Peter Braddock and Mike Roberts. This project is funded by the National Science Foundation and logistic support provided by the United States Antarctic Program.